Hey guys, LickFi here, and welcome to another Career Mode player review. Today we're taking a look at Eric Deere, another defender, and this review was requested by Hank, so thank you for the comment. And if you guys have any players in particular you want me to review, make sure you leave it down in the comment section below, and I'll try to get to them. As well as that, if you guys can leave a like on the video to continue showing your support on this series, that would be greatly appreciated. And with that said, let's get into the review today. At the beginning of Career Mode, Eric Deere has a 73 overall rating at the age of 20, showing great potential and a value of $1.5 million. When you go ahead and send them an inquiry, they're only going to say $3.7 million, so not too much more than his actual value. So that's always great news to hear. So I'd say you can pick him up for about $2 million or so, maybe a little bit more, maybe a little less. I think it depends on your situation. We'll take a look now at his player information. You can see he's got some good stats for a defender. 6'2", he is a medium-high work rate defender, 3-star weak foot, and 2-star skill moves. The power header trait and the strength specialty, good stuff for a 73 rated player. And we'll move on now to his actual attributes. And they've got some good attributes mixed in there. The 87 strength really does stick out for me, as well as the 82 shot power. If he does manage to get forward, he can get some shots on target, and when they are on target, they're going to be pretty powerful. He also has some decent sprint speed and good pace, as well as pretty decent passing for a center back. But let's go ahead and jump ahead and see what his stats look like when he reaches his peak. 11 years later, Eric Deere reaches an overall rating of 83 and an estimated value of $8.5 million, an increase of about $7 million from the start. He also manages to pick up the aerial threat specialty to go alongside the strength specialty. And he does grow pretty much across the board, not so much in the physical attributes, but to be fair, he starts off with pretty decent attributes for a center back in the physical department. And especially in the technical area, he manages to grow, which comes in handy for some of those attributes, including the heading accuracy, standing tackle, sliding tackle, and some of those relevant ones. But let's jump ahead to the goals, and I will talk about his pros and cons. Alright, jumping on to the clips now, and I have to say Eric Deere was a pretty fun player for me to review. I wouldn't go on to say he was the best center back that I reviewed, but he was still pretty fun in his own right. We'll start with the pros, and the first pro that I'm going to be talking about is his strength. For me personally, his strength was incredible, so a lot of those one-on-one challenges where they're running alongside each other, he's going to win those. And to go alongside that, he has great standing tackle, so he just manages to make some incredible tackles. And his final pro for me was his sprint speed. You know, when he reaches that sprint speed, it is pretty decent for a center back, but to go alongside one of his cons, his acceleration, it takes him a while to get to that top sprint speed, so that can be a downfall every now and then. And lastly, if you want to be picky, he doesn't have very good dribbling and on-the-ball statistics, but he's a center back and you don't run into that problem too often. And I dare say that I would give this guy a chance, give him an overall rating of 8.5 out of 10, and I hope you guys did enjoy this review today. If you did, do me a favor, drop a like down below, and subscribe to the channel if you're new around here. And until next time, this has been FlickFi. I'll be talking to you all again soon.